Morning, everybody. Good to see everybody on this beautiful morning, relatively speaking. As always, do please take a copy of the bulletin. Lots of good information in there about our parish, about our surrounding area, just to highlight a few items. One that's not in there, but just to bring to your attention, as I mentioned last weekend, this weekend is Good Shepherd Sunday, and we do have our annual Good Shepherd collection today that goes to support the retired priests of our diocese and partially funds the Michael J. Murphy Retirement Home for Priests over on East Gore Road. So we ask you to please be as generous as possible. Ask you to keep in prayer the young people from our parish who will be receiving their first communion today at noon. Again, that is a public celebration. Everyone's certainly invited to attend, but do please keep the young people who are receiving Christ for the first time in the Eucharist in prayer. Religious education families are asked to please make sure you register for next year. We'd like to get those registrations in early so we have some numbers so we can go ahead and start ordering resources. So please register if you plan on attending religious ed next year. Also, this is for confirmation candidates. Our confirmation program usually starts up earlier than most. So we do ask folks who are juniors and seniors who are planning on being confirmed next year to please make sure you get your registration in early. Finally, I feel I owe everyone an apology. I understand there's been some confusion about our 160th anniversary celebration that's coming up for the school. And you've seen that advertised, of course. It's going to conclude with a big alumni weekend celebration the first weekend in June. And we hope all of the alumni, both alumni students, alumni teachers, alumni parents, plan on attending that. But through the committee work, we are planning as part of that to have some Chinese auctions, some raffles, and so forth. And as part of that, we're auctioning off and raffling off some school memorabilia. And I misunderstood the committee. I thought when we were talking about raffling off some banners, we meant some of the banners in the gym. But that is not what we are doing. We are not raffling off the athletic banners hanging in the gym. Those will remain. So I apologize if that created any confusion. That was my understanding, and it was wrong. So we are not raffling off or auctioning off or giving away the banners in the gym. Those will stay. The same with any major trophies, championships, all those kinds of things are going to stay too. We are planning on raffling off or auctioning off some of the trophies that maybe people don't even know about anymore. There's dozens of trophies. They're not even in the case. They're over in the woodshed out back. And I'd pay you $100 right now if you can tell me what's back there, because nobody knows what's back there. So don't come to me and say, those trophies are important to me. You don't even know what's back there. So we're not raffling off or auctioning off the banners. We're not raffling off, auctioning off, any of that kind of stuff. There are some banners that I guess are used on tables for displays and stuff that say St. Boniface School on them. Those are the banners we're talking about. So I apologize for any confusion on that. That was my fault. And if you have any questions, please see me after Mass. Please stand and join in our entrance antiphon found on page 153 in the Breaking Bread. Page 153 in the Breaking Bread. The merciful love of the Lord fills the earth. The word of the Lord, the heavens were made. Alleluia. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Please join me in reciting the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, our brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that gives me strength. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. A reading from the first letter of Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. You have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
May the Lord be on your lips and in your heart that you may proclaim his holy gospel worthily and well. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere, is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice, as a shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers." Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord. Well, good morning. Father Mark and I are continuing our series of teaching about the Mass. So today we are teaching about what is called the Liturgy of the Word. And we just had it. The Liturgy of the Word begins basically with the readings as we go into this part of the Mass that we call the Liturgy of the Word. And during the normal Liturgy of the Word, we have a number of things that are happening. The first of all is a reading from typically the Hebrew Scriptures. Second, we will do the Psalm. Third will be the epistle or the letter, usually from Peter or James or Paul. And then finally, the Gospel itself. And it doesn't necessarily have to be in that order, because during certain seasons, like the current season of Easter, instead of the Hebrew Scriptures, we are reading from the Acts of the Apostles. So we hear during Easter the formation of the very early Christian community in and around the communities of Jerusalem. The major thing for the readings is basically the gospel, because we hear Christ himself speaking to us in the gospel. And we treat the gospel as something very, very high in our church. And if you've seen me walking in with the book is held high. That red book is the book of the Gospels. It's not the Bible, but it's the book of the Gospels. So we reverence that. We consider that book a tabernacle, just as valid as this one here, because it contains Christ in his words. And we respect that book. We enthrone the book for all to see with that sense of Christ being with us. And one of the hidden things that happens, particularly when Father Mark reads the gospel, or the person who is supposed to read the gospel is the deacon, is that at the end of the gospel, what do you see us do? We bring the book up and what? We kiss it. Why? Because it is Christ's presence to us. Just as we come in and process with the introductory rites and we kiss the altar because it represents Christ for us, the Word of God as Christ is at, we kiss the feet of Christ right at the end of the gospel. Now, if the bishop was here, where would we take the book after the gospel reading? We would take it over to the bishop and he would kiss the book. He would be the head of the church, and the deacon would bring that book over to have the bishop kiss, right at the end of the gospel, the feet of Christ. The little things sometimes we don't see or hear. And when we do the end of the gospel, when we do kiss the book, there's a little silent prayer that nobody hears other than the one who is praying it. And that prayer is, through the words of the gospel, may our sins be wiped away. So the person who proclaims the gospel is praying for all of you, all of the community, for our sins by those words to be wiped away and are gone. Now, following the readings, there's supposed to be some sort of elucidation on what we just heard. This is called the homily. It is not a sermon. A sermon delivers a very technical component of what we heard in the readings. The homily is a conversation between us and the community. And in the homily, basically what we want to do is to try to bring these readings that we just heard, not only from the old time of the Hebrews and of Jesus Christ, we want to make those readings important to us now, in the current time. So when we do a homily like this, we want to make it present for you now. What does it mean for me now as we go through that process? So a good homily will give you something to take home, to kind of do, to look at your lives again and maybe change something or to do something a little differently that the homily has explained that from the scripture. Now following all of this, we will go back to our seats and then we will stand up and we will profess what is called the creed. And in our book, we have two different creeds that we can say. First is the Nicene Creed, which was formed at the Council of Nicaea. And the second is the Apostles' Creed, taken back to the time of the apostles. And what is kind of neat to do, if you ever had somebody come up to you and say, you know, as a Catholic, what do you believe? You can simply start, I believe in one God. And go through the whole creed. This is what we believe. The word creed comes from the Roman word credo, C-R-E-D-O, which of its form, how it derives from, is the word for heart. It's what we hold in our hearts. It's what we believe. Then at the end of the session that we call the liturgy, the word is what we call the universal prayer, okay? Or the prayer of the faithful. It's the prayer for everybody in the world. And some people ask, well, you know, why aren't we praying for this one person who died for us this week? Or why aren't we praying for this one specific thing that we're doing this week? It's a universal prayer. It's to include everybody in the church, in the entire world. That's why we call it universal. It's not specific to certain things. It is for everyone in the whole world. And that's basically what we call liturgy of the word. So why is that important for us today? How do you hear the shepherd's voice? How do you hear that shepherd who is calling us to live a Christian life? How do you hear what Jesus is calling you to do? First of all, you hear it in the readings. We heard it in the gospel today. I am the good shepherd. I am the gate. And we say, well, you know, every Easter we hear these readings and it's the same thing all the time. Good! Because then we begin to hear that in our lives and it's in our head and we can kind of reflect the gospel right along with the person who's reading it. I understand that. Jesus is the good shepherd. You've heard the word. And most importantly, when you hear the word, when you say your beliefs in your heart, it prepares you to take that word to the rest of the sheep in the world. All the people who are out here beyond our church, and to take them the word so they hear the good shepherd and follow him. Only those who recognize the voice of the shepherd will be a follower, will be a sheep. Let's hear that word. Let's go forth and give it to others.
Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Gathering our prayers together, we offer them to our Heavenly Father, who we know hears us and answers us.
Our response is, Risen Jesus, hear our prayer. Let us pray to our God, for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Lawrence, our Pastor, Father Mark, and all the priests and leaders of our church, as they continue to lead us on this Good Shepherd Sunday. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
We pray that isolated and persecuted churches may find strength in the good news of Easter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
We pray for the leaders of our nation and all those who work to make us safe and guard our freedoms, the freedom of speech, the freedom of worship, the freedom from want, and the freedom from fear. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
We pray today for blessings on our first communicants, that they and their families will stay close to Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
We pray that more young men and women will hear and answer the call to priesthood, the diaconate, the religious life, and today we pray for Deacon David Whitebird as he prepares for ordination. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
We pray for a continued blessing on our pastoral planning, and we pray by the power of the Holy Spirit that in the midst of all life's varied changes, we may never be separated from our Good Shepherd, who guides us to the springs of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer.
Jesus, our shepherd, have mercy on all who mourn, especially the members of our family, parishioners, and friends, and for Joan Helsley, for whom we remember in a very special way at this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord.
Risen Jesus, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, giver of all gifts, we continue to thank you throughout this Easter season for the gift of your risen Son, who is our good shepherd. We ask you to help us hear and follow his voice wherever he leads, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Again, our second collection today is the Good Shepherd Collection. We ask you to please be as generous as possible. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of
his name. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Boniface, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope and Lawrence our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you with their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer to one another the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.